Tanya dulu Pak Ustaz, kenapa ular-ular kecil-kecil keluar?
Ada barang ikut dia.
With all the paranormal work I've done, I've had the chance to meet so many people that have come up to tell me that they've had black magic done to them, to their family, to their friends, to their loved ones. So it got me thinking, right? We are in modern Singapore. Why is black magic still rampant? And it's not just in Singapore, but it's in Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, all over Asia, black magic is being practiced. So I decided to do my homework and I was reading books, I was talking to people, and so I said, why not come up with a documentary, a mini documentary, to educate people like you about black magic and about white magic. So this documentary is about Bomohs.
Ilahi diberkati rohaniah Nabi Muhammad Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Wa barakati ruhana Sayyidina Sultan Awliya Syekh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani. Wa barakati ruhaniah Syekh Badr Abu Qadir Sahna Sabandiyah.
When someone first told me about Pulau Besar, I was like, Pulau Besar, it means big island. So what's this big island? And then this person told me that a lot of Bomohs, they practice both white and black magic, they go to Pulau Besar. And then while I was there, I found out that people that are down on their luck, they visit the island too and they get amazing results. And then there's also, you know, the folks that are disabled and they go there and miracles happen, okay? So this place is buzzing with energy and I had to see it for myself. I met this really cool guy and he had two pet monkeys with him and his name is Jack and he's a caretaker of one of the oldest tombs on the island.
Pulau Besar is very famous. Okay. Every Bomoh, every pawang or whatever traditional healer, traditional magic, whatever, they must know Pulau Besar. So Pulau Besar, one of the center. I believe they got two Bomoh, two type of Bomoh. One Bomoh is those who didn't care. When you need, you come to seek his help, he don't care whatever you want. So either he's black or white, as long as he can generate income from you. Okay, another one is a Bomoh who really doing white only. So you don't want to involve in any black magic things or whatever, he will ask you to go to find another person.
My name is Mahmud bin Putih. Orang panggil saya Datuk Mod. Tok Mod orang panggil. Cuma ubat tradisional untuk pesakit-sakit yang kena hysteria dan tak sadarkan diri ataupun kena saruk di jin dan hantu. Tadi perbuatan saya, saya gunakan ubat saya. Gunakanlah satu keris dari pusaka nenek moyang saya untuk tahukan penyakit orang itu apa sakit dan apa dia kena. Keris ni lah satu besi yang 700 tahun besinya dan saya gunakan untuk memulihkan semangat-semangat semua manusia yang ada penyakit yang aneh. Jadi keris ni boleh beritahu macam mana penyakit dalam badan tubuh manusia itu datang dari mana dan di mana benda ni ada di dalam tubuh badan.
Spell dia pun lah. In Malay, dia call it pengasih lah.
Yes.
Pengasih. And a pengasih, another one is a pembenci. So, pembenci means you want to make the people to break off lah. Then, pengasih, you want to make the people fall in love with you. With the magic. Okay. they got one apa batu putih here, batu lesung, batu lesung, yes, batu lesung, batu lesung. I mean in front of the makam Sultan Arifin. Okay, there's one time got one tree inside there. Okay, so people take the root, okay, the root, okay, make with oil, minyak pengasih. They call it cenuai laut, cenuai laut. Okay, I've seen the minyak before, and then the result memang quite impressive lah. Memang sebab bukan kata orang, kalau you pakai, binatang pun
come
to you. Binatang pun memang very friendly with you.
Kadang-kadang badan sakit, kadang-kadang kepala bisa, kadang-kadang tidur tak boleh, kadang-kadang macam you duduk jalan sana jadi macam orang mental. Kadang-kadang you tak boleh ingat ni dunia. Kadang-kadang you tengok orang you takut. When you see the people, you pray the people. You cannot see the people. So pun ada macam tu.
Ada satu contoh, saya dulu Jurong ada satu perempuan namanya Zurina. Zurina binti Abdullah, dia orang Kuala Lumpur. Dia sudah satu tahun sakit. Kalau nanti suddenly dia absent minded, pingsan. Pergi bawa dokter, dokter kata di sini ada najis dalam perut. Tapi dokter mau operasi tak jadi. Bertahun bertahun. Satu ketika, one day saya datang sana. Ada Perti. Saya lagi pray, Perti. Dia mau datang masuk rumah, karena kita lagi pray, dia pingsan, jatuh. Sudah pingsan, jatuh. Habis pray, orang itu dia punya husband panggil saya. Saya lihat, dia punya mata merah. Oh, ini mesti kena magic. Saya punya feeling, perasaan. Saya suruh ambil air. Terus saya ambil air, dia saya pangku. Ini orang tadi, ibu-ibu, Bu Zurina. Saya ambil air, saya baca phrase, saya doa, terus saya sapu muka dia sampai kaki dia. Dia duduk, muntah. Saya bilang bawa kamar. Habis Perti makan sama-sama, sudah orang pulang. Saya bilang sama suaminya, sini kamu. Ada, kamu pegang dia punya badan, nanti saya pegang kamu punya tangan. Saya kasih energi. Saya baca doa satu jam. Dah saya dalam baca doa, guru saya datang bawa bunga. Saya lihatlah. Okay, saya bilang kamu besok ambil flower, seven kinds, terus itu limau, bawa sini besok saya datang. Terus habis saya lagi doa, saya suruh dia mandi. Mandi, tengah mandi, itu dari sini, dari dua ini, apa nama ini, dari dia punya ketiak. Itu ular kecil, ulat kecil-kecil keluar. Ulat kecil-kecil keluar dari sini. Sampai dia bilang, tanya dulu Pak Ustaz, kenapa ular kecil-kecil keluar? Suaminya panggil saya, sudah biar aja mandi terus, sampai ulatnya habis semua. Udah siap dia mandi, ulat dah habis keluar. Baru saya bilang, itulah yang ulat ada dalam perut kamu, orang bikin. Kalau tidak percaya, besok pergi hospital check up. Check up itu najis, kata dokter, yang dulu tak ada lagi, hilang. Itu salah satu macam itu magic. Dia tak tahu ada magic dalam, sudah lama sakit baru tahu. Jadi saya bilang tadi, ini magic tak boleh kita tahu suddenly. Mesti nak satu minggu, satu bulan baru tahu. Dia sebelum kawin sama suami, dia banyak boyfriend di Kuala Lumpur. Jadi yang dapat orang Singapura, orang Kuala Lumpur sama dia sakit hati. Kuala Lumpur pergi Bomoh, bikin dia sakit. Macam itu.
Visiting Pak Mot was a blessing in disguise. You know, with my paranormal work, you are prone to being followed by entities. So all this while, I thought that was exactly what was happening. You know, I was seeing shadows in the house. I was having a lot of sleepless nights. And little did I know that it had nothing to do with my paranormal work. And it was a lot more personal than I ever could imagine.
Sam ada follow sama you.
What?
Oh, someone following you.
Ada barang ikut dia. See?
Nothing's following you.
Dia goyang ni tengok. Thank you. Terima kasih. Sometimes that you don't see the shadow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I have.
Almost every day.
See? Tadi mau dah tahu. Pain, isn't it?
Can you describe pain?
Oh, man. I don't know, it's painful. I feel very sad as well.
It feels like a needle being driven into my
foot. Macam jarum, betul. No? Pain, isn't it? Slow.
Slow. Yeah, just a bit.
Jangan pergi dulu lah kat ni lah. Kena relax dulu lah. Nangis semai.
You think somebody is doing something to me?
Yeah. I don't know your friend ah, your girlfriend ke, I don't know lah. Somebody to cam you. Bukan hantu ikut dia. Ada orang cam dia. Ada orang bikin dia. Dia gunakan jarum ataupun telur ataupun orang mati punya tanah. Jadi situ dia boleh magic, buat magic. Dia put dia 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 draw your punya body that the patung bell, patung kita panggil apa?
Doll.
Like the doll, and then you put your name, and then they take the needle, all the cocok like this lah. And you sakit sana, you sakit sini, sakit sana. Kalau sekian macam tu, you nak kena cari satu barang untuk pakaian. Mean kalau orang Melayu cakap azimat ataupun protect you punya diri, something to pray with you, and then something very black yang want to come to you cannot come.
Pasalnya mereka merasakan ada seseorang mengirim penyakit kepada tubuh mereka. Saya boleh lihat itu. Ketika saya suruh mereka lie down atau berbaring, lie down speak Malay berbaring, nah, di tempat tidur, saya periksa, itu boleh saya rasakan melalui tangan saya. Ketika saya pegang dia punya badan, kaki atau tangan atau di kepala, saya akan membaca doa dari awal hingga akhir. Setelah itu akan saya berikan apa yang saya lihat ketika saya berdoa. Apa yang saya lihat. Contoh. Example. Saya melihat air. Air itu akan saya pray. Akan saya doa, saya berikan dia. Kemudian, kadang-kadang saya lihat daun. Daun hijau atau daun sirih. Saya akan pray itu daun sirih, saya berikan kepada dia. Dan nanti saya lihat seperti bunga-bunga. Flowers. Itu artinya dia harus mandi, harus have to take a shower, karena ada saya lihat bunga. Jadi semua petunjuk atau guidance ketika saya berdoa itu datang daripada guru-guru saya.
Off camera, I found out who is responsible for this curse, and it's two people. I find it very hard to understand why people would want to do this to another person, like. It, to me, it's just evil. But you know, the funny thing is that in my heart, I don't feel any anger towards these two people. But I do believe in karma, and I hope they know what the word means. In the next part of this documentary, we're going to dig deeper into black magic. and you will see some really freaky stuff. And you will also find out how else you can protect yourself against evil.